Dear students, we'll continue with our fourth module. The first topic is safety management system. Safety management system is a continuous improvement process which can reduce the various hazards and prevents incidents in an industry. So it has been initiated, that is a safety management system has been initiated to protect the health and the safety of the various employees. It should be integrated into everyday processes throughout the organization. Next, we'll see the various features of an effective safety management system. The first feature is a people, that is a committed, motivated, competent and skilled workforce. The second feature is a planning in order to see any foreseeable risk as well as hazards in the industry. The third is the programs in order to identify and control the various hazards. The fourth feature is a progress, that is, there should be a periodical measure to check the compliance as well as the regulatory requirements, to audit the SMS system, that is the safety management system, and review its performance. Finally, the performance, that is, the system should be able to adopt to a leading standard and to evaluate the safety measures. Now let's see what is the role of management in providing safety to the industry. So the management should be able to provide the leadership, vision and resources needed to implement an effective safety and health program. The worker safety and health should be made as a core organizational value. The management should be fully committed to eliminate various hazards to protect its workers and to continuously improve workplace safety and health. It should also provide sufficient resources to implement and maintain the safety and health program. The management should also demonstrate and communicate their safety and health commitment to workers and others. It should also set an example through its own actions, that is, what should be done and what not to be done should be perfectly demonstrated. So there are various strategies that is to be initiated to provide safety by the management. The first strategy is to communicate the commitment to a safety and health program. That is, there should be a written policy which is signed by the top management, which describes the organization's commitment to a safety and health and also providing a promise to establish and maintain a safety health program to all its workers. The second strategy is to define program goals. That is, the management should set expectation from managers, supervisors and workers and all other workers. The goals and the objectives should focus on specific actions that is required to improve the workplace safety and health. The third strategy is to allocate resources, that is, to implement the safety and health program as well as to pursue the program goals and to address the program shortcomings when they are identified. The final strategy is to expect performance, that is, the management should be able to give a positive environment, an open environment to its workers, which can encourage communication about safety and health among the workers. Now there are various benefits. The first benefit is obviously the economic benefit, which deals with the monetary benefit. The second benefit is the ethical benefit, which deals with boosting up the morale of the workers. Now we'll see different safety management techniques. The first one is effective safety and health programs, which has been already discussed in our previous modules. Then comes the properly trained inspectors, either from the industry itself or from outside the industry. The next technique is the effective safety inspection program, which is either planned or spontaneous or can be special inspections. Then the guidance system, which should be used to maintain a consistency in inspections. Then if there is any problem, the problem has to be properly recorded and reported. Adequate follow-up and monitoring is required to reduce such problems. Now, various safety inspections that has to be included in any industry. The first one is a senior management safety walk, which includes the observations done by the senior management to various safety and non-safety items, then safety related deficiency which has to be forwarded to appropriate corrective individuals. The next program is the supervisor's formal weekly inspection of their own work in order to identify the hazards, dangerous operations, accident prone workers, etc. The third is the supervisor's ongoing observation of the work on a regular basis, that is day-to-day life basis. The fourth is the supervisors and workers' weekly formal mini audits. Then comes the safety committee, which need to have monthly inspections. Then finally, equipment specific inspections in order to identify faulty equipments. Now, based on the level of severity, the hazards could be categorized into three: level A, B and C. So A hazard is any condition or practice that has the potential to cause loss of life, body part or complete loss of structure, building or equipment and materials. Immediate corrective action is required and the activity should be stopped till the hazard is corrected, for example, loose electric connections. In level B hazards, it includes any condition or practice that has the potential to cause a serious injury, illness or property damage. This requires serious attention and urgent solution, for example, workers smoking in a flammable area. Level C hazard is any condition or practice having probable potential to cause non-disabling injury or non-disruptive property damage. These hazards are to be eliminated but not on an emergency case, for example, workers using hammer with loose head for odd jobs.